Welcome in. Unfortunately, a somber edition of our video podcast, Musings from the Mountains. Some quick reaction from a very surprising, in a bad way, West Virginia loss at home to Texas Tech, 38-17, in a game that really probably wasn't that close.
No, it was. I mean, when you allow Texas Tech to score in its first five offensive drives and you make mistakes like West Virginia did, that's the kind of results you're going to get. Like I said, just from start to finish, just no rhythm at all for West Virginia on all three sides of the ball.
Yeah, West Virginia was down 28-3 before they could really blink their eyes in this game. Some turnovers, inability to completely stop anything Texas Tech could do.
Miscommunication.
Yeah, miscommunications on the defensive side, you name it. It was just a poor game offensively for West Virginia. Poor game defensively for West Virginia. I know you look at the final numbers here. You know, West Virginia rolled up 549 yards. You know what I'm going to say if you know me.
The famous quote.
Yeah, you can't score yards. They're ineffective in the red zone. They cannot put the ball in. You got what you got. I guess when you look back at this game, what's surprising to me is how listless, you know, West Virginia came out the gates, especially defensively. You played very well against Baylor on the road. Thought that would come home and carry. I was very surprised with how Texas Tech really had their way. West Virginia could not get any pressure up front, led to some mistakes in the back end. And when Texas Tech did run the football, didn't run it for a lot of yards. I mean, you look here, 127 total yards, but it was efficient yardage. When they needed to get three yards, they got four. When they needed to get 4 yards, they got five. They converted a couple red zone attempts.
Well, four touchdowns too. Four touchdowns there.
Yeah, so it comes down to efficient running is what they're able to do. For West Virginia, still can't run the football. 18 carries for 51 yards, threw the ball over the place. They threw the ball over the place in this game, but it didn't really matter. It was a bunch of scoreless yards. Austin Kendall had an up and down game. I think he left a lot on the field. I think he'd probably be the first person to tell you that. Unfortunately, we were not able to talk to him in post game, but I think that he'd be the first person to admit that. He underthrew some balls and left some potential touchdowns on the field, at least two by my count, and they overthrew another. And then one in the end zone really wasn't his fault. He had two receivers running in the same area. You did get to see Jarrett Daigie. I thought he played well late, but how much can you take away from what he did that late in the game? I don't know.
I mean, and the same goes for freshman running back Tony Mathis. Saw his first game action of the season today. Head coach Neil Brown thought he looked pretty good out there, but yet again, you got to take into account, you know, who Texas Tech had on the field on defense at that time. But like you said, Keenan, my takeaway is it's such a disappointing, you know, game, especially coming out of that road loss to Baylor, where there was a lot of promise there, especially defensively. You come out back in Milan Puskar Stadium for the first time in almost a month, and you lay an egg out here. I mean, it's very, very disappointing.
Yeah, battle of 3-5 teams. This, if you look on paper, this was West Virginia's best chance for a win at home against Texas Tech. Now you're 3-6. You have to win the last three if you want a bowl game. That's not going to be easy. That might be an unattainable climb at this point. Neil Brown's press conference, though, I thought something was very interesting. Unprompted at the end, he kind of, you know, put it on himself. Said that this team's going to grow up. It doesn't look like good football right now, but he appreciates the fans showing up. And it was a really good crowd today for the most part, especially with the temperatures. But put it on himself, you know, said that they are going to get this program to match what fans have come to expect. So we'll see if that unfolds. That goes back to the old mantra that we won't mention, but I think people know it by now. But at this point, that's where West Virginia finds itself. You know, this is a 3-6 team looking for anything, and now they're going to go on the road to play a Kansas State team, which is arguably playing its best football of the year at this point. Not going to be easy. I think we'd be remiss to not talk about Sam James' game. 14 catches for 223 yards. Might have had 300 if he wouldn't have had a couple drops, but a huge game. I think that you're seeing some positives there. He's got to be able to hang on to the football, but some positives that you can build on moving forward. You got to try to reach and grasp for positives, but not a lot today. This was just a really surprising result. That the one thing that I guess is discouraging from this all is you could say a lot of things about this football team and the way they've got 3-5, but effort and intensity had not been one. They played hard, they just didn't play well. Today, I think you could question that, and that's not something you want to see.
Like numerous times this season, the response is going to be huge for West Virginia next week on the road against Kansas State. You know, Big 12 is never easy. They want to be bowl eligible. These three games left, it's not going to be easy at all. On the road at Kansas State, home against Oklahoma State, and then on the road to end the regular season at TCU. I mean, it's not going to get any easier for the Mountaineers from here on out.
I hate to rule out a bowl game, but they're going to have to change things in a hurry if they want to start thinking about a bowl game. But it is what it is. Mm-hmm. West Virginia's 3-6. I don't think that is surprising. I think more it's kind of how things unfolded today is what the big takeaway was. But this has been our rapid reaction. We'll have a lot of stuff coming up on the site. If you enjoy this video, I do recommend you once again hit subscribe. We do these multiple times a week. Usually do it in the studio, but we're doing it on Mountaineer Field today. So we'll have more, but thanks for tuning in again to Musings from the Mountains.